All right, today we're talking about Google quality score and how to increase it. Now, too many people get hung up on this. It's not always a bad thing to have a lower quality score, and we'll talk about why. Let's get to it. Hi, Mike Mancini with PPCVideoTraining.com, and today we're talking about how to increase your Google quality score. So just in case you don't know what Google quality score is, in the upper right hand side, you will see a link to our last video that talks about exactly what it is, why you should worry about it, and also why sometimes you don't need to worry about it. So before we dive too deeply into this, I do have to say this. People obsess. They obsess over this thing called a quality score. They've got to be perfect. It's got to be a 10 out of 10. It doesn't have to be a 10. The Google quality score is a rating that looks at the relevancy of the keywords, of the ads, and the landing page or user experience. It's just like when you went to school. If you got an A, it didn't mean you were going to be better in life than somebody that got a C. All it means is that there's a possibility that you might come up higher on the page for less cost per click. So Google is essentially rewarding you for doing your job right. Now, the quality scores are always going to change. But the reason why I hammer that this is not the be-all, end-all of what you should be looking at is because it's not the be-all, end-all of what you should be looking at. The most important thing you should focus on is the performance of that keyword. In one of my campaigns, I literally have a keyword with a quality score of 2. It's embarrassing. I don't show that to other people. But the reason it doesn't bother me is because that keyword is killing it. I actually get a lower cost per click than most of the other keywords in that campaign, as well as more conversions than any other keyword. It's been running for years. But for some reason, Google does not see that as a win-win. I don't really care. All I know is it's working for me. But if you absolutely need to increase those quality scores, and sometimes you do, here's a couple ways to do it. Number one, check the ad relevancy to the keywords that you have grouped in that ad group. You don't want to have too many keywords in an ad group. You want your ads very tightly knit. So if I'm advertising plumbers in Minneapolis, if that's one of my keywords, I don't want to have other keywords in that group, plumbers in St. Paul, plumbers in Chanhassen, other areas. I want just keywords talking about plumbers in Minneapolis. So plumbers in Minneapolis, Minneapolis plumbers, Minneapolis plumbers near me. Get the idea? Your ad needs to focus on those keywords. So when somebody types one of those keywords in, that keyword or a version of it should show up in the first headline. The reason is you want that to catch their eye. If they type in Minneapolis plumbers and that keyword is the first thing that they see, so it stands out, catches the person's eye, they will click more. I promise. So what you're doing is increasing the relevancy of that ad to that person's search. Google is seeing, oh, if they type in this keyword, we're showing this ad, that's obviously relevant. Also, in the rest of the ad, throw in that keyword somewhere else, especially in the first description. You don't want to just repeat the keyword, but you'd like to use versions of it or talk about it. Make sure that ad is hyper-relevant to the keywords in that ad group. And guess what? Once you've done that, you have just taken out two of the factors. You have keyword relevancy, you have ad relevancy, and that's going to increase your click-through rates. I promise. Because the more people that see that versions of those keywords, we're used to scanning. A lot of the time these ads aren't even read anymore. We're just scanning. Oh, that's got the keyword, click. That's gonna help your click-through rates. Now the biggest thing that people run into or the biggest problem that they have is dealing with the landing pages or the user experience. Now some people get confused by that, but you shouldn't. The user experience is essentially what happens when that person gets to a landing page. So if somebody clicks on the ad and they get to a landing page and they hit the back button immediately because they don't see anything that they were looking for, that's bad. We want to keep that from happening. So you should never be sending everybody to the front page of your website. you should be sending them to hyper-targeted landing pages. If you've got 10 services, you don't want to be sending people from who look at an ad about service one to a page that's got all 10 services. You want to send them to a page that's talking about service number one. Does that make sense? And in fact, we have landing pages for almost every single ad group or very close to it because of the fact that if they're looking for plumbers in Minneapolis, the first thing we want them to see is a headline talking about plumbers in Minneapolis. We have gotten so used to hitting that back button. Remember, that's bad. And it's because we've gotten so good at scanning pages for what we're looking for. We're not really reading it as much as we're scanning it. Think about it. How long are you on a page before you hit that back button? Years and years ago, it used to be a lot more. Now it's around 2 seconds. If people don't see exactly what they typed in or a version of it as soon as they hit your landing page, they're gone. That's still bad. So you've got to give them what they're looking for right away. That's the first part of the experience, making sure that they spend some time on the page. Now, you need to get them to take an action, whether that's scrolling down the page, clicking on buttons, filling out a form, clicking the phone number to call. Those are all user actions. When somebody takes actions on a page, that's increasing their user experience because they're finding what they're looking for. So, where are your ads taking people? How are your landing pages set up? It's really something that you can split test. But when Google in the quality score says you have a bad landing page experience, take note, see what's going on the other end. And please do not send people to the front page of your website. You are wasting that traffic. If they're looking for a product, send them to a product page. If they're looking for a service, send them to a service page where they can take action on that. All right, so those are a few ways on how to increase your Those are a few ways that you can increase your quality score in Google Ads. Do you know of other ways that can help increase your quality score? Let everybody know. We'd love to see those. Throw them down in the comment section below. And if you like videos like this, please do us a huge favor. It really helps us in YouTube's eyes. Click that like button below, hit the subscribe button, and that little bell icon so you'll be notified of when we release new videos each and every week. And if you want to see more videos like this, over to the right-hand side, you'll see another one of our Google Ads Q&A sessions, as well as some other related Google Ads videos. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.